Okay, a couple changes to highlight in the way that tasks work. Mark it at 7. I'm not gonna go over the speed improvements, but the tool does work significantly different in terms of how tasks are processed. This is specifically about how tasks are edited. So if we go to Tools and Manage Tasks, a couple of specific things here. So to start with, I removed the rename task element. Now, if you want to rename a task, all you have to do is just click inside of the task box label, and you can rename your task. The other thing that has changed is that in order to edit task, the task had to always select the edit box. Now, just double-clicking on the task will open it up. Also, when you used to create a task, you would have to create the task and then go back and select the task. Now, when you create a new task, it automatically opens the task for editing. So the assumption is that you probably want to edit it. The last thing that I wanted to point out in this is task locking. So here is a task. I'm going to artificially lock the file. So let's say you were doing something, say like you were editing a task and the Mark had crashed, or maybe you're using the new debugging tool and something ends up causing you to have to stop. Mark edit internally locks files so that they can't be edited by more than one person. So if I was to go back here and select this task, this should be the one I just locked. Used to be that you couldn't do anything until the task was unlocked, which meant having to go to that folder and deleting it manually. Now it tells you that the macro is currently locked, potentially by another user. Asks if you want to go ahead and edit the file. If you tell it yes, the lock's removed, and you can now go in and edit the file. Last thing, two things I wanted to highlight. One is I've had some folks ask if it would be easier to debug macros. So say you wanted to, you have a macro with a long list. This obviously is a long list. Let's say I had a long list. And I wanted to delete one of the elements in the task, but I really didn't want to delete it. I really just wanted to comment it out. So let's say I wanted to get rid of this one. I can now right-click on it and comment the task out. So now when I save it, that option will no longer be treated as a task that's run. It's now treated as a comment. When I want to have it back, I can uncomment it and it comes back. So now it will run as part of the task. The last thing is I had some folks ask about debugging tasks. This isn't really a debugger, but it'll allow you to step into a task and walk through the steps so that you can see what the results are at each step. So you click on the debug button. It will ask you to open a file that it's going to apply the task to. Pick a small one. This is a lightweight editor. So it now runs and will ask you to, if you'd like to continue to the next step. So it'll show you down here your results, and it'll load the file into here with the changes. Unfortunately, the message box is a blocking file operation, so I can't scroll up and down in the editor. So if I wanted to see the changes and I couldn't see them in the screen, I would have to tell it no and then evaluate the elements in the debugger. I might figure out a way to change that here shortly, but at this point, this is how it works. So I would go ahead and say yes, continue the next step. So the next step was to delete all of the fields with a 0xx. So you can see in my box here, I removed all the control fields, tells me how many deleted. Okay, I'll go ahead and continue one more. And you can see the 500 field was added. And I can scroll up here and see the fields that are added here. So here's my test field. So this way I can step through the tasks and see the results at each individual step, or at least what the results should be changed to. And like I said, I'll try and figure out a way to embed the make it so that the user can continue to interact with the debugger, so you can see what kind of changes have taken place. But for now, you at least get the results down below, and then when you're finished, you have the results log here, and that way you can see what's happening at each step of the task. Since tasks are procedural, I think sometimes if you're testing individual task outcomes, you may not realize that the data has changed significantly enough that between your tests and when it actually gets run in the list, that maybe something's changed that's causing a task to not work correctly. So this will give you a way to do a little bit more debugging on the task list. The last thing that's going to be added, and I have to get an Alma instance installed so that I can show this, is that on materials where you have an ILS integration set, the tasks will, you'll be able to select tasks to run automatically when you import data into MarkEdit through the API, and before export, it'll run a selection of tasks if you've asked it to. That way, if there are things that you need to do to a file, either on import or on export, you can just have the program do that automatically for you. So those are a couple of things, and I'll record those later when I have when I have the Alma instance finished, because I want to show a couple of other changes. That's the updates to the task processing, at least within the editor. There's a couple changes to the command line tool. The experimental bit is now the default task mechanism. And like I said, tasks now process significantly faster due to a change in the way that files are handled internally. So hopefully that'll make a significant change for folks who use tasks for different workflow purposes.